Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Alice Network, a novel book by Kate Quinn. The story revolves around one shuddering young spy, Eve, and a young pregnant girl, Charlie. Then, read the part written by Quinn after the end, and search the internet to learn tie details of many of the characters, and what happened. Kate Quinn does a great job keeping the basic history accurate, and adds just enough artistic license to make an interesting novel. The narrator is a dropout from Bennington College, pregnant, and heading with her domineering mother to Switzerland to take care of the problem. It was a breath of fresh air in history, where women are often written out of the story, or downplayed at the least. The main characters you follow in The Alice Network are fictional themselves, but Kate Quinn fits them in perfectly. They never feel out of place, or unbelievable, and they don't clash with the characters who are based on real-life individuals. Every character rings true. And if the action and heroism sometimes seem incredible, well, truth is stranger than fiction. It's a small slice of the lives of women who risked their safety to help the Allied cause against the German war effort in World War I. There is a lot of time shifting, which becomes much clearer after the first few chapters. The women's spy network was compelling, and the tension of possible discovery was well done. Avoiding spoilers, the character who was tortured for information was quite interesting, and had a lot of depth. Historical facts and intriguing historical figures are seamlessly woven with a plausible fictional story and characters that enrich the history. What makes it better? Take something that deserves the spotlight but has somehow not received the notice it deserved, and make it shine. Women are so often lost to the pages of history, even when playing critical roles like The Alice Network was. The price they paid at the time and through the decades after is deftly portrayed throughout. Even though it was historical, the plot had some unexpected turns, and both the historical and fictional characters really came alive. There was a lot of history about women's experience during those time periods, which was very interesting. The other story follows a young woman in 1949 who is looking for her cousin who was lost in France during World War II. The book does a great job of explaining how society and war can affect women in particular. This is one of those novels that alternates between two storylines taking place at different times in history. In this case, the more interesting story is the one that follows a young woman who is recruited to be a spy behind German lines in World War I. So this is a worthwhile read if only to discover the amazing courage and daring of this group of women. This is not a fun read by the pool type of book, but is definitely a book you must read. This book takes place in post-2 England, and France is one of the main characters tried to find out what happened to her cousin in the war. She ends up partnering with Eve, who was a spy in World War I, and this book ties their two stories together. It tells her story, and does her justice, but it also tells the story of many fictional characters, and in spite of being fictional, their stories are very real. It deals heavily with issues of PTSD, and the human side of war. But it's also about a young woman finding her way in life, and an older woman coming to terms with her past. It was wonderfully well written, with characters that fully come alive, and a compelling plot that literally made it impossible to put down at times. The book is laced with enough historical accuracy to make it compelling on a number of levels. The fictional part is stunningly well done, but the non-fictional parts are just as stunning and jaw-dropping. This is a must-read book about women spies used during the World Wars. Kudos. It goes into the nuts and bolts of spying during wartime, as done by young women. The author's note at the end of the book enumerates what was true and what was fictionalized. Where exactly can women find a man like that? But the book offers a good story, well plotted, absolutely no boring parts, a little history, and a good ending. One of those books where you really want to get to the end, so you know how it turned out, but you don't want to get to the end, because you don't want it to be over. And most importantly, the story Quinn tells of the importance and dangers of this female spy network is so intriguing that this novel is difficult to put down. There were times when the writing could have been tighter, where repetition of phrases occur within paragraphs, or when pieces the reader already knows get repeated with no additional point to the retelling. Saucero Charlie is a young woman who embarks on a desperate adventure to find her missing cousin, Rose. The answers her family gives are not enough to satisfy the utter sadness Charlie has in losing her best friend. Saucero the two travel miles, gaining small clues along the way until finally they catch a break that leads them closer to the answers they are looking for. Saucero, this book goes from past to present, and takes you along with these two women on their quest for answers and closure they so desperately want to find. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.